Sorry guys, make sure you stand till the end because there is something very important to do, otherwise your car will not start. So make sure you stand till the end.
Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel guys. We have a new mechanic here in the shop now. We'll be working on Mazda guys 2.3 turbo engine that you can find on CX-7 and Mazda Speed 3. What we'll show you guys where to find and how to replace the crankshaft position sensor. We'll guys have more than 200 videos on this car, and every car we get at the shop, this engine will be taken completely apart. Why? Because our mission guys is to save you as much money as we can. All we need in return, subscribe to the channel, like the video and drop a comment below, let us know if the video was helpful, if you have any recommendations and all that stuff. So, now, we started taking this engine apart guys, we'll have a video how to put timing chains and all that stuff, we'll have an engine replacement as well, so please check it out on the channel, quite a few things. And you don't need to take anything apart on the top of the engine, nothing at all. That's what the engine looks like put together. What do you need to do? You will need to jack, okay, your front right side up. Always use a jack stand. Put the wheel and the tire under the vehicle in case it drops so it doesn't kill you. And always use a jack stand because if that jack fails, guys, okay, all that weight will fall on you. So, now with that being removed, guys, okay, you will have a cover here that you need to remove with just a few clips, super easy to remove. We have the video on the channel if you need to check it out. But once you remove that cover, guys, okay, you're going to see your crankshaft pulley right here. This is a crankshaft pulley known as harmonic balancer in the United States. And this is your crankshaft position sensor. Looking at the engine out of the car, okay, let me explain to you where it's located. This is the same 2.3 DC engine. Out of the vehicle, this is your crankshaft pulley. This is your crankshaft position sensor, guys, right here. This guy. He has two bolts. You can see two 8mm socket bolts, okay, and one wire. How you guys disconnect that wire? Let us show you quick. Okay, right here towards the back. Okay, there is one thing that you press down, okay, and you pull out. Okay, and that sensor is disconnected, guys. So that's what we'll be doing on the one there. Okay, we're going to go ahead, remove the two bolts, and we'll disconnect the wire. So guys, we need 8mm socket. Okay, this is the crankshaft position sensor right there. Okay, one bolt is out. Now we just have one more on top. Perfect, the sensor comes out. Now we need to disconnect the wire. I show you how to do it, guys, on the other engine. This one had an extreme oil leak, and as a result, guys, everything is covered, guys, in oil here. So I'll come towards the back. Okay. Now we should be able to pull it out. Okay, it is stuck a little bit. Okay, but it comes out. And this is, guys, your crankshaft position sensor. In the description of the video below, guys, you'll be able to find where we buy them from. You have the link, part numbers, all that stuff, so you can, guys, see where we get them for a good price. Always check that out. So, now, guys, every time you remove your crankshaft position sensor, guys, you're going to need to calibrate everything. Okay, and I'll explain what we mean by that. Okay, that sensor has pretty wide holes here, so it can move up and down. And if you move it a little bit off, okay, what will happen? The timing of the vehicle will be off and it will not perform right, or it may not even start. So, when putting it together, guys, okay, I'll explain there are two ways to do that. Now, if you haven't removed the harmonic balancer, it will be super easy. If you removed it, okay, we'll show you another way what needs to be done. Now, if you guys haven't removed the harmonic balancer, okay, you will need to bring that harmonic balancer. Okay, you're going to turn it, okay, let me show you, a little bit more. Okay, until that hole aligns with a hole underneath it. Okay, there is one hole underneath it. 6mm bolt M6. Okay, we'll need to be screwed in there. So let me make sure, okay, which way I need to go now. Okay, just a little bit more to the right.
Okay, and there is a special place, okay, where you can screw it. Now I need to go maybe back a little bit. Ah, too much. Okay, perfect. And the ball now goes by hand, guys. This is your TDC point if the crankshaft harmonic balancer wasn't removed. Never remove that because you have to do the timing of the vehicle and all that over and over again. So, this is your TDC point. From that point on, guys, okay, installing the crankshaft position sensor, okay, you need to install it on the 20th tooth, starting from here, tooth number 20, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20 tooth, guys, and he needs to point right in the middle, okay? On the crankshaft, there is a mark in the middle of the sensor, and that mark needs to align with the middle of the 20th tooth. And when you do all that, guys, it's going to align perfectly fine. Now, if you align it too up or too down, your timing will be off, and the time when the spark is supposed to ignite will be different, and your engine will not perform right. So that's how you do it. Also, guys, you can use a locking pin. Okay, this is for the crankshaft. There is one bolt that you need to remove. Okay, right here, you install that bolt and you turn the engine. Okay, clockwise until it stops, and it's going to contact that pin, guys. And this means that this is top dead center TDC point, and you need to adjust, okay, your crankshaft position sensor as well. So that's something that we should have added, guys, because that's something very important, otherwise your car will not perform right. So hopefully, guys, the video will be helpful to some of you. Please, guys, hit that subscribe button for more videos, and see you guys next time.